Hi everybody, welcome back. We're now into soul music. And of course, we can't talk about the history of rock and roll without getting into soul music. James Brown, considered soul brother number one and also the godfather of soul. Looking at the first number one R&B hit, Try Me, it charted at number 48 in the pop charts, as well as the group's first appearance on the Billboard Hot 100. You'll find it's very, very old school R&B. Check it out.
And your love will always be true. Oh, I need you. Hold me.
Hold me.
I want you right here by my side.
Beautiful. Now Think, which is a Five Royale cover. Let me show it here.
About the good things, about the bad things, about the right things, about the wrong things. The lady before you leave me, be locked, and I'm the one who led you. Think about the sacrifices that I made. Think about the hard times that I've spent with you.
You can really hear that backbeat coming into play. Brown's success peaks in the 1960s with the live album Live at the Apollo, and hit singles such as Papa's Got a Brand New Bag.
Papa's in the state. Ain't you hip? What's that new breed? Ain't no drag. Papa's got a brand new bag. And this is crazy to see. He's not too bad, but he's fine as what he can be. Ain't no drag. Papa's got a brand new.
As you can hear, that's your typical 1-4-5 blues progression, of course, with that new interesting backbeat that obviously soul music, or James Brown's soul music, is known for. Here's I Got You, I Feel Good, and this is on Ed Sullivan's 1966 show.
I was talking to young Jim Brown, James Brown. He was telling me that his rhythm and blues are rooted in Southern gospel singing. Now, he's a Southerner, of course. He was born in Augusta, Georgia, where he worked on a farm, picked cotton, worked in a coal yard, and always sang his songs. So we are delighted to present James Brown on our stage on this show. So let's have a fine welcome for our very fine talent.
Second to none. And of course, it's a man's world, and in this case... And side note, I really have to say, as far as the backing tracks, I think you're going to really love this. Check it out.
This is a man's world. This is a man's world. But it wouldn't be nothing, nothing, without a woman on the day. You see, man made the cars to take us over the road. Man made the train to carry the heavy load. Man made the electric light to take us out of the dark. Man made the boat by the water. Like Noah made the ark. This is a man's world. But it wouldn't be nothing without a woman on the day. Man thinks about a little bit.
And I do hope you go through the rest of that. It's beautiful. It really is. During the late 1960s, Brown moved from R&B blues and gospel-based forms and styles to the Africanized approach to music making that influenced the development of funk music. And I don't need to tell you how great funk music is, of course. P-funk and funkadelic, of course, you know, continuing on to modern times and even thinking about, you know, Red Hot Chili Peppers and Rage Against the Machine. You know, by the early 1970s, Brown had fully established the funk sound after the foundation of the JBs with records such as Get Up, I Feel Like Being a Sex Machine.
I wanna get up and do my thing. I wanna get up and do my thing.
Yeah.
I wanna get up and do my thing.
Yeah.
Can I get into it?
Yeah.
Like a
what?
Like a
what?
Like a
what?
Like a
what?
Like a sex machine.
Yeah.
Moving.
Yeah.
Doing it, you know.
Yeah.
Can I count it out?
Count it out.
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 One, two, three, four.
Get up. Get on up. Get up. Get on up. Get on up. Get on up. Get up. Get on up.
Get up.
Get on up.
Stay on the scene.
Get on up.
Sex machine.
Get on up.
Get up.
Get on up.
Get up.
Get on up.
Stay on the scene.
Get on up.
Sex machine.
Get on up.
Baby. Shake it off.
One of the things I'd like to point out, of course, is the most important aspect of this is the backbeat. They're really sticking on one, maybe in some cases two chords, and many times maybe potentially following the blues, you know, three chords essentially would be the most that you'd hear in many cases up to this point of what we've heard. And it's really truly, you know, about the backbeat. It's about the drums, the bass, and how that all works together. You know, the groove is truly amazing. Here is also the Payback. I'll just play just a touch of this too. And again, my disclaimer on this, I do apologize if they do make us take any of this down, you know, based on trying to upload this to YouTube.
Hey! Got the payback! Revenge!
Just beautiful stuff. You know, you hear the horns, of course, you hear the backbeat, you know, the guitar playing, you know, utilizing a lot of the rock, you know, elements, you know, with foot pedals and also with the amplification. Brown's also become notable for the songs of social commentary, including the 1968 Say It Loud, and I'll just play a touch of this as well. And I do apologize if they take this down, of course, on YouTube. But at the same time, of course, I've got this here for you, so you can always go back to it.
Put your bad self.
Great. Brown continued to perform and record for the duration of his life until his death in 2006 from congestive heart failure. Brown recorded 16 number one singles on the Billboard R&B charts, and he holds the record as the artist to have charted the most singles on Billboard Hot 100, which did not reach number one on that chart. Brown is ranked seventh on the music magazine Rolling Stone's list of 100 greatest of all time. And so with that, James Brown, truly unbelievable. Continuing on, getting into Ray Charles, considered the genius of soul. He created a unique style of soul music by combining rhythm and blues, gospel, and original country blues styles into the music that he recorded for Atlantic Records. This is This Little Girl of Mine. This is all the way back with Atlantic that we had covered, and I think you'll find, you know, the early stuff with Ray Charles is absolutely beautiful, very, very different. Check it out.
Baby, let me hold your hand until I make you understand. Oh, baby, let me hold your hand. I really believe everything would sure be grand.
And the same thing, blues progression. The one thing that you're hearing in this particular case is that, you know, almost toy piano sound. Very, very different. What I'd say in 1959, also on Atlantic. That keyboard sound is a Rhodes sound. That, excuse me, a Wurlitzer. Basically blues, right? He also contributed to the racial integration of country and pop music during the 1960s with his crossover success on ABC, most notably with his two modern sound albums. This is You Are My Sunshine.
The other night, as I lay sleeping, oh, I dream I have you. I have you in my heart. But when I woke up this morning, I found out I was mistaken. Do you know that I hung my head and cried? Oh, you are my sunshine.
You are my sunshine.
Oh, my only sunshine.
My only sunshine.
Oh, girl, you make me,
you make me happy.
My skies are gray.
My skies are gray.
And hit the road. Here's Hit the Road Jack.
Mm-hmm.
Ray Charles' recording Hit the Road Jack hit number one for 2 weeks on the Billboard Hot 100, beginning on Monday, October 9th, 1961. Hit the Road Jack also got a Grammy Award for the Best Rhythm and Blues Recording. The song was also number one on the R&B side for 5 weeks, becoming Ray Charles' sixth number one on that chart. Wilson Pickett. He was also a major figure in the development of American soul music, and you know, very, very famous. And in fact, you can't go into a bar and not hear Mustang Sally. Pickett recorded over 50 songs, which hit the U.S. R&B charts and frequently crossed over to the U.S. Billboard Hot 100. He was initially famous for singing I Found Love in 1962 with the Falcons. Old school R&B, right? Best known hits, In the Midnight Hour, which he co-wrote, and Mustang Sally.
I'm gonna wait till the midnight hour. That's when my love comes tumbling down. I'm gonna wait till the midnight hour.
Hear the horn sections, of course. You've got, you know, the blues beat happening. You've got, you know, so many beautiful elements that, you know, when it comes down to it, you know, obviously, you know, soul music is truly of my favorite types and genres of music. And truly, you can't, you know, understate the importance of soul music in the history of rock and roll. So, for example, Mustang Sally, walk into any bar and you're going to hear it. Doesn't matter if it's a rock band, blues band, you will hear Mustang Sally 9 times out of 10 if it's a cover band. Check it out. And, of course, in this particular case, check out his stage presence. Truly amazing.
Everybody shake that thing tonight, all right? That's what he said. Guess you better show your Mustang now. What I say now? Mustang Sally now, baby. Yeah. Guess you better show your Mustang now. Oh yeah, man, I can wear all it all over town. Ow! Got to put your flat key on the ground. What I said now, yeah, you know what I did. All you wanna do is ride around Sally. Sally. Oh, you wanna do ride around, Sally, yeah. All you wanna do is ride around, Sally, yeah.
Now, those vocals are amazing, aren't they? The impact of Pickett's songwriting and recording led to his 1991 induction into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Continuing on, Otis Redding, known as the King of Soul. After appearing at 1967 Monterey Pop Festival, and of course you guys are familiar with that, check this out.
It's been a real groovy day and a great evening, and here, let's bring on with a big hand, Mr. Otis Redding.
Pop Festival. Now, after the Pop Festival, he wrote and recorded the iconic Sitting on the Dock of the Bay.
Sitting in the morning sun, I'll be sitting when the evening comes, watching the ships roll in. Then I watch them roll away again, yeah. I'm sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Ooh, just sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. I left my home in Georgia, headed for the Frisco Bay. Cause I've had nothing to live for, and look like nothing's gonna come my way. So I'm just gonna sit on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. I'm sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time.
So this is where it gets weird. A couple days after the recording, he died in a plane crash. Otis Redding received many accolades after his death, including the Grammy Lifetime Achievement Award, an induction into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and the Songwriters Hall of Fame. He received the nickname the King of Soul. In addition to sitting on the dock of the bay, also he's known for respect.
All I'm asking for a little respect when I come to talk. Yeah, 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 yeah. You know, do me wrong, honey, if you want. You can do me wrong, honey, while I'm gone. But all I'm asking for a little respect when I come home. Yeah, yeah.
And this is live the day before the plane crash.
They all spoke so gentle, yeah, yeah, yeah. And it makes easy not to bear. Oh, no, no. Young girls, they don't forget it. Love is
but it's all so easy. All you got to do is try, try. Till it gets it. Yeah, man. All you got to do is know how to love her. You got to hold her, squeeze her, never leave her.
Live. And last, of course, but not least, Aretha Franklin. Lady Soul or Queen of Soul? Following her signing with Ahmet Erskine and Jerry Wexler of Atlantic in 1967, Franklin achieved huge commercial acclaim and success with songs such as Respect, of course. And of course, that's a cover, but at the same token, that's for the most part the song the way that most people would, you know, be used to hearing it.
What you need to, you know, I got it too. All I'm asking you is for a little respect when you
just
come
a little
home.
Bit,
hey, baby,
just a little
when
bit,
you're home.
Just a little bit,
mister,
just a little bit.
I ain't gonna do you wrong. Why you go?
And of course, You Make Me Feel Like a Natural Woman.
Looking out on the morning rain, I used to feel so uninspired. And when I knew I had to face another day, Lord, it made me feel so tired. Before the day I met you, life was so unkind, and you're the key to my peace of mind. 'Cause you make me feel, you make me feel, you make me feel like a natural woman.
Woman.
When my soul was in the lost and found,
truly beautiful. And Think. This is live. Sorry about the quality on this one, of course. And I do apologize, of course, if they let us, you know, hopefully they'll let us play, you know, and keep these up. But if they do have us take these down, of course, always remember you can come back to this on Canvas. Think was a huge hit. These hits and more helped her to gain the title Queen of Soul by the end of 1960. Franklin eventually recorded a total of 112 charted singles on Billboard, including 77 Hot 100 entries, 17 top 10 pop singles and 100 R&B entries, and 20 number one R&B singles, becoming the most charted female artist in charts history to date. Franklin has won a total of 18 Grammy Awards and is one of the best-selling artists of all time, having sold over 75 million records worldwide. Franklin's been honored throughout her career, including a 1987 induction into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Please let me know if you need anything, and feel free to email, call, text. Let us know if you have any questions. Take care, everybody. Have a great weekend.